Step into a time machine and travel back millions of years to a world where the oceans were ruled by a true titan of the seas, Megalodon. This extraordinary creature, whose name translates to Big Tooth, was a species of mackerel shark that inhabited the ancient waters from the early Miocene to the Pliocene epochs. With teeth that could grow as large as a human hand, Megalodon was a formidable predator that struck fear into the hearts of all marine life that crossed its path. Originally thought to be a close relative of the modern great white shark, Megalodon has recently been reclassified into the extinct family Otodontidae, which diverged from the great white shark during the early Cretaceous. According to the latest estimates, it could grow up to a mind-boggling 20.3 meters in length. That's longer than a school bus and more colossal than your wildest imagination. Talk about a creature that puts all other predators to shame. But that's not all. It's not just about length, it's also about weight. Based on scientific extrapolations from fossilized vertebral centra and comparisons to its modern cousin, the great white shark, it could weigh up to 103 metric tons when it reached its maximum length. That's equivalent to the weight of a small army of elephants. It's a beast so massive that it could make even King Kong tremble in fear. And to keep its colossal body fueled, this ancient leviathan would have needed to devour 98,175 kilocalories per day. Now let's talk about those teeth, the stuff of legends. These bad boys were thick, roused, and built for destruction. With a bite force estimated to be between 108,500 to 182,200 newtons, its jaws were like a hydraulic press on steroids, capable of crushing through the toughest of prey. Speaking of bites, Megalodon's bite diameter was estimated to be 3 meters, several times larger than that of an average-sized white shark. This ferocious bite would have allowed it to take down prey with ease, making it a top predator in the ancient oceans. But that's not all. Studies suggest that it may have had a unique adaptation similar to modern white sharks, called regional endothermy. This means that Megalodon could have regulated its body temperature, allowing it to swim and hunt in colder waters, and giving it an exclusive advantage over other marine creatures in those environments. Reproduction was a pivotal aspect of Megalodon's survival, and scientists believe that this colossal shark species produced live young. But how did they give birth? Was it ovoviviparous, where eggs were retained within the mother until they hatched? Or viviparous, where the fertilized embryos received continuous nourishment from the mother? The answers to these questions still elude us, adding to the enigma of its reproductive methods. Estimates based on juvenile teeth suggest that newborn Megalodon pups may have been at least 2 meters in length. These little ones were already larger than most adult humans as they ventured into the ancient seas. It's a fascinating insight into the early stages of its life cycle. Courtship and mating behaviors of Megalodon also remain shrouded in mystery. However, evidence points to the species utilizing nurseries for its young. In a 2010 study, a Megalodon nursery was identified along the Panamanian coast, marked by the presence of juvenile teeth from different stages of life. This shallow, warm water nursery likely provided the young Megalodons with access to a diverse range of smaller prey, allowing them to grow and thrive. Additionally, it may have served as a strategic location for adults to intercept attacks from other predatory shark species, such as hammerhead sharks. Its menu consisted of a wide variety of prey, ranging from fish to marine mammals, making it a versatile and highly effective hunter. Fish were likely eaten by young Megalodons, as they honed their skills and grew in size. But as they matured, they set their sights on much larger targets. Baleen whales, toothed whales such as ancestral forms of modern sperm whales, dolphins, and killer whales were all on the menu for the mighty Megalodon. These massive marine mammals, some measuring over 100 feet in length, were no match for the colossal jaws of Megalodon. Armed with rows of serrated teeth that could slice through flesh and bone with ease. But it didn't stop there. Sirenians such as dugongs and manatees were also part of its prey repertoire. These slow-moving herbivores would have been easy pickings for them. Even seals, which are known for their speed and agility, were not safe from it. The competition for food and the constant struggle for survival in the ancient oceans would have been intense, and it stood at the pinnacle of this marine food chain, reigning supreme as the apex predator. Its extraordinary hunting prowess and unrivaled size made it a force to be reckoned with, a true king of the ancient seas. This massive shark had a cosmopolitan distribution. From subtropical to temperate latitudes, it made itself home in a wide range of maritime environments. Shallow coastal waters, areas of coastal upswelling, swampy coastal lagoons, sandy littorals, and offshore deepwater environments, you name it, Megalodon conquered it. As you can see, this ancient leviathan had no boundaries when it came to its habitat preferences. It was able to tolerate temperatures ranging from 1 to 24 degrees Celsius. Fossil remains of it showed that specimens were larger on average in the southern hemisphere compared to the northern hemisphere. With mean lengths of 11.6 meters in the southern hemisphere and 9.6 meters in the northern hemisphere, it's clear that size mattered for these ancient sharks. Additionally, it was found to be larger in the Pacific Ocean compared to the Atlantic Ocean, with mean lengths of 10.9 meters and 9.5 meters respectively. This suggests that it preferred the warmer waters of the Pacific, where it could grow to massive proportions and reign as the undisputed king of the sea. But size wasn't the only factor that determined its dominance. The distribution of body sizes among Megalodon fossils also revealed an interesting pattern. The overall modal length, which is the length that appears most frequently in a population, was estimated to be around 10.5 meters. However, the length distribution was skewed towards larger individuals, indicating that larger body size may have provided an ecological or competitive advantage for these mighty sharks. Unfortunately, as the Pliocene epoch arrived, despite its once global dominance, its reign came to an end, leaving behind only fossils as evidence of its once majestic existence. The exact cause of Megalodon's extinction is still a hot topic of scientific debate. The changes in global climate could have played a role. During the Pliocene epoch, around 2.6 to 5.3 million years ago, Earth experienced a period of global cooling known as the Pliocene-Pleistocene glaciation. This resulted in a drop in sea levels and a decrease in the availability of prey for Megalodon, which predominantly hunted marine mammals like whales. Its transient lifestyle could have also contributed to its downfall. It had a wide range of habitat preferences, from shallow coastal areas to offshore deep waters. However, studies have shown that adult Megalodon were not as abundant in shallow waters and mostly inhabited offshore areas. This could have posed challenges in finding sufficient prey to sustain their massive bodies, leading to declines in their populations. Competition with other marine predators could have also played a part in their decline. As top predator of its time, it faced competition from other large marine animals, such as other species of sharks, marine reptiles, and early cetaceans that were also vying for similar food sources. This fierce competition for prey could have put immense pressure on their populations, potentially leading to their decline. In recent years, Megalodon has become a favorite subject for thrilling movies like The Meg, where we get to see this colossal beast wreak havoc on the big screen, sending chills down our spines and keeping us at the edge of our seats. But it's not just movies and TV that have caught on to its hype. Video games have also capitalized on this fearsome creature, featuring it as a formidable opponent in various underwater adventures. Gamers get to experience the thrill of encountering a Megalodon up close, battling it for survival, and experiencing the sheer terror of being in the presence of such a colossal and powerful predator. But amidst all the awe and fascination, one question still lingers. Is Megalodon still lurking in the depths of our modern oceans? Could this ancient behemoth still be out there, waiting to be discovered? Well, that's a mystery that continues to puzzle scientists and shark enthusiasts alike. So, who knows? Maybe one day we'll be lucky enough to catch a glimpse of it. And if you're into cool stuff like this, make sure to click on the like and subscribe buttons below. By learning about Megalodon and other prehistoric animals, we get a better idea of just how diverse and complicated life on Earth really is. And if you're curious about other prehistoric animals and want to know more about them, then you should definitely click on the video on your screen right now. We'll tell you everything you need to know about this fascinating topic and help you deepen your understanding of these incredible creatures.